Welcome to Talk and Cheese Podcast. One DJ, podcast, one comedian, two other guys.
Talk and Cheese.
Come on.
You are an
awesome. Begging it.
This is on BJ. Alright,
so listen, yeah. You know, I saw something where, was it on UK Gossip? Where they were talking about how they're going to be teaching, schools are going to be teaching kids as young as 6 years old how to play with themselves and stimulate their, you know,
right now,
their private parts. Yeah. What is your opinion on that?
I didn't want to talk about them fucker.
That's wrong. Like, that's,
you understand?
Wrong.
I'm not talking about wrong, no child porn.
You
know right
what
I'm saying?
You see what they might try? They might try to force kids to grow up too fast.
Isn't it?
You understand what I mean?
Like, by the time you're 28, you have no sperm left.
Yeah, talk about that. Wait, stick a pin point. That the subject. You know, see, me see something on my article where a boy dead from masturbating 50 or 80 time a day or something like that. I see it.
What did he die from?
Then heart attack.
My masturbator,
how did your heart get involved with your masturbate?
Your heart rate, dog.
Your heart rate. That's a bit mad, though.
Dog, that's a bit. He must have just find out about it and say, yo.
That's a bit mad. 80 times. 80.
Come on,
Ross.
I was masturbating. That's why I know I'm old. I was masturbating the other day and I fell asleep midway.
I just walk around it.
Just test it out. Thanks.
That's a stage thing. That's good.
That's a stage response for me.
That's funny. But yeah,
son walking.
In regards to that, yeah, I think that the schools, yeah, are doing some mad things with the kids, man. They're training the kid. They're teaching the kids some foolishness.
Different type of thing.
Like,
man.
Crazy.
That's like paedophilia, though. What do you do?
That's what I'm saying. I don't even want to talk about it. Kids touching.
You do, like, get out a dildo and show them in front of them. What are you doing,
that's
blood?
What I'm saying. That's my worst nightmare, yeah, when I'm masturbating them.
How are you going to teach?
Come burst in the room and I said, start. Knock! Knock!
How are you going to teach a child?
You know, you feel bait. Like, what did I say? You know, that's in the baitness. Because everybody sees, you don't see what happened, but you see the baitness.
Why are you jumping up then?
Yeah, like.
Are you chilling?
Like. And closing laptop. And getting
vexed.
Shut my door! What?
They'd be like, can I borrow the laptop, daddy?
What? What do you want? And that's the worst thing. And the one time I see them with the laptop, I'm thinking, shit, did I delete my shit?
Yeah, you get paranoid, isn't it?
I'm paranoid.
Yeah. Stop.
But no, you're right. You're right, Chris.
I can't.
It's not good. What they want to do to these kids nowadays? I understand. Like, kids be kids. Make them be children. Make them be picnic. Make them go outside, go play a kickball and things.
I don't think that will go through, though. Yeah. I think there'll be too much
go
uproar.
Just like with the toilet thing that they must start doing, schools are now having the toilets where
unisex toilets.
Unisex
toilets. They can't fuck off, man.
Like, it's like.
And then kids allow, and then there's a school where you can't, there's no gender, they're not boys or girls,
yeah,
they're people,
and they can come into school and wear skirts,
boys can wear skirts, and they're just messing up the children's head, and the agenda is crazy. I don't understand it, but there's something happening, and these things are being passed through Parliament. Just
but this is why,
and then we don't
remember, but you got to realize. I don't want to go back into that deep conversation, but remember, the world is not run by these governments on rare of these people who we see. You know? It's run by these paedophile people at the head of
big
the fucking
paedophile
chain.
Ring,
the Parliament, yeah, and the Boris Johnson and the Trumps, they're hair in the chain. There's people up, you understand, that controls them and controls the world. The media, let me show you, they gave you, Shaw and Hobbs, Fast and Furious, the last of it, when they just done anything, I said, yeah, them and they done this, and it's just world news. That's like reality. If they really want to fuck with you and say, like, C6 is up here,
don't even say that.
I'm just saying, but
I'm editing that. Don't say that. don't say that.
All right, but you know what I'm saying.
But you
know,
say it,
like,
you
don't
say
it.
But you, I know,
well.
But you're not.
I understand, but don't say it. It's cool. It's gone anyway. No one even.
That's like
what you said.
You know, like yard man. You know what? My
body. Don't say that.
Man, a body man thing. My name, white my body. You know, in a drone joke with them joke there.
You never hear the little you. Did you hear it? Have you seen it?
That's C6. Not even joke. Me not run with that thing there.
No, don't.
You want him, man? But yeah, same sentence.
If the government want it.
But you know what I'm saying? It's the people at the top, blood.
Mm. Yeah, but we have to know
they pass around books.
How can paedophiles get the least sentence out of, and that's the worst crime you could even think of?
You know what? Yeah, let me tell you something. I've been waiting to be stopped by the police, you know. I've been waiting to be stopped. I want him to stop me and tell me that I matched the description. I was watching a video of them stopping a youth and saying he was in the middle of somewhere, and they were like, you resemble the kind of people that are doing the county lines drugs. I would love them to stop me and say that, or you fit the description of drug dealers or anything, just so I can say you fit the description of the average paedophile. When's the last time you were stopped?
You were getting dashed.
When's the last time you were stopped and they went through your phone?
I'm going to say that though.
When's the last time you were stopped and they went through your phone because of what you match and the description of what you fit?
So you never see the video.
You think they're listening to you?
Doesn't matter, I want to do it.
You know Pac Jam?
Yeah.
You know Pac Jam?
Yeah, I saw it, the video.
The video when he gets stopped at the airport.
Yeah.
Just because he never said, it's what he's asked to say. He's a DJ from
Birmingham.
But he got stopped at the airport. He's going to pick up his, I think when he picked up his children and baby mother. And the policeman see him walk past and must say hello to him. And he just ignored the policeman. And the policeman stopped him because he never said hello back to him.
Really?
And give him a hard time investigating, want to know why I'm here, all them things. And to me, it's just like, yo, like, for real? Something like that, like, you know what them do? Them are provoking him. They arrest him.
But you know what? Most policemen are being like, bullied, though. Like, it's just part of their authority thing. They're fucking idiots. They got insecurity.
Things like that need to have some kind of repercussion, man. Because you are holding up a man time now just because he never said hello. So
but,
what?
But you see, the thing is, you know why they're going to... I watched that video and Pac Jam called me and asked me to share it. But you see what it is? It's at the airport. And they're going to say that he acts suspicious. They're smart on how they choose, where they choose to... The guy was like, look, you're in the airport. I've said hello. You looked a bit shifty. If, like, obviously, based on all the terrorist stuff that's going around and all the scare tactics that are going around, it'd be justified if it was someone else. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, that is why they did it at the airport. He couldn't do that on the high street. Mm. But he could do that at the airport and then use it. You look shifty at the airport and then we will say, you got to move correct at the airport. Do you get what I'm saying? So it kind of justifies their behavior.
Yeah.
But anyway, back to what them are doing, it's wrong. Like, them need, that's why I feel parents as well, if you need, that's why you need to know what going on with your kids in school, out of school, because some of these lessons, they will just start have them with your children, you don't even know them are going. Yeah.
But a lot of parents don't pay an interest in their schools.
No,
their,
but that's why they need to.
They need to go and see what's happening.
Yeah.
Would you know what would be good for most parents to try and do is be on the board of governors for their children's school.
But they ain't got time for that.
But you stay there, but when your son is learning about all these things, then you're going to moan. But if you was on the board of governors or someone else was on the board of governors that had the link to all the other parents, then maybe you can deal with it from the inside.
That's why I'm glad they ain't got kids, fam. I'm not trying to go for them. Fuck.
So that is.
Just leave people pick me alone, man.
Mm-hmm.
This your boy, Dizzle Comedian. You've been watching Chalk and Cheese podcast. Stay tuned to next week. It's the best
Chalk
thing ever.
Chalk and Cheese podcast. For the podcast. Yeah.